Imagine starting each day with a distinct sense of purpose, undeterred by setbacks, unaffected by chaos, and unwaveringly focused on what truly matters. This might seem almost superhuman, but it was the everyday reality for one of ancient history's most powerful figures, Marcus Aurelius, a Roman emperor and Stoic philosopher. His personal writings, preserved through the ages, offer not just historical musings but surprisingly relevant advice on harnessing self-discipline amid life's noise. Today, we're delving into the core of Stoicism, examining its principles as practical tools for leading a more disciplined and fulfilling life. Stoicism teaches us to turn adversity into advantage, emotional turmoil into peace, and life's unpredictability into a source of strength. Whether you're dealing with daily stress, seeking inner peace, or aiming to boost productivity, the Stoic way of life provides profound insights. In a world full of distractions and instant gratification, Stoic philosophy anchors us in the virtues of wisdom, courage, justice, and moderation. It's about more than just enduring life. It's about thriving, no matter what comes your way. So, if you're ready to transform how you perceive and tackle life's challenges, join us as we explore the powerful, transformative teachings of Marcus Aurelius and how they can help you cultivate a strong, disciplined life today. As we embark on this journey through Stoic philosophy and the profound insights of Marcus Aurelius, if you appreciate our efforts, please subscribe to our channel. Don't skip any part of the video, because if you're here, you're different from most. Consider yourself exceptional and stay tuned for the unique insights we'll uncover together. Number 1. Self-discipline starts with finding your purpose. Marcus Aurelius emphasized the importance of self-discipline and purpose in his writings. In his Meditations, he often reflected on the idea that understanding one's purpose is essential for cultivating self-discipline. He believed that every individual has a specific role or duty in life, and recognizing this role provides the motivation and drive needed to stay disciplined. One pertinent passage from his Meditations is, "At dawn, when you have trouble getting out of bed, tell yourself, 'I have to go to work as a human being. What do I have to complain of if I'm going to do what I was born for, the things I was brought into the world to do? Or is this what I was created for? To huddle under the blankets and stay warm.'" This highlights the connection between purpose and action. Aurelius argued that by understanding and embracing our purpose, we naturally develop the self-discipline required to fulfill our duties. He saw purpose as the foundation of a meaningful and productive life. When we have a clear sense of what we are meant to do, it becomes easier to overcome procrastination and inertia. This purpose-driven approach to life not only helps in achieving personal goals, but also contributes to the greater good, aligning with the Stoic belief in contributing to the community and the world. In summary, Marcus Aurelius taught that self-discipline starts with finding and embracing your purpose. By doing so, you align your actions with your inherent duties, fostering the internal motivation and drive needed to stay disciplined and achieve your goals. In today's world, discovering your purpose can often feel daunting. We live amidst numerous choices and distractions that can divert us from our true paths. This is where Stoic wisdom becomes not just beneficial but crucial. Stoicism guides us to strip away superficial desires and fleeting emotions to uncover what is truly vital for our well-being and growth. It prompts us to ask, "What truly deserves my time and energy? How can my actions today contribute to the greater good and my personal development?" To apply this principle in our lives, consider what you are naturally drawn to, where you find deep satisfaction, or what challenges inspire you to act. These are clues to your purpose. Once you identify it, the Stoic practice of daily reflection becomes invaluable. By consistently aligning your actions with your purpose, and by saying no to what doesn't serve you and yes to what does, you develop the self-discipline needed to live a meaningful and impactful life. Take this insight from Marcus Aurelius and apply it daily. Each morning, ask yourself, What am I meant to do today? And each evening, have I lived true to my purpose? Over time, this practice will not only enhance your self-discipline, but also transform your life into a more purposeful and fulfilling journey. Number 2. Count on yourself. Marcus Aurelius, the Roman emperor and Stoic philosopher, emphasized self-reliance and personal responsibility in his writings. One of his key teachings in this regard is encapsulated in the phrase, "Count on yourself." In his work Meditations, he frequently underscores the importance of looking inward for strength and guidance, rather than relying on external circumstances or other people. One relevant passage is, "Look well into thyself. There is a source of strength which will always spring up if thou wilt always look." This reflects his belief that true strength and purpose come from within, and that individuals should trust in their own capacity to navigate life's challenges and stay true to their principles. By cultivating self-discipline and introspection, one can live a more purposeful and fulfilling life, independent of external validation or support. In Stoicism, the focus on what is within our control is essential. Marcus Aurelius frequently spoke about the power of the self in facing life's challenges. By relying on ourselves, we tap into our inner resilience and strength. This principle teaches us to trust in our abilities to navigate through life's uncertainties and adversities. It's about building confidence not through arrogance, but through competence and a deep understanding of our own capacities and virtues. This self-reliance is both liberating and daunting. In today's interconnected world, where opinions and advice are always accessible, learning to listen to our inner voice can be challenging. However, Stoicism encourages us to filter out the noise and trust our reasoned judgments. Aurelius believed that this internal guidance was the most reliable counsel because it is rooted in reason and virtue. By counting on ourselves, we also develop autonomy in our decision-making processes. It enables us to make choices aligned with our values and principles rather than being swayed by external pressures or fleeting emotions. This autonomy is crucial for maintaining personal integrity and living a life true to oneself. So, how can we start to truly count on ourselves? It begins with small steps, making commitments and keeping them, setting personal goals and working towards them independently, and taking time to reflect on our decisions and their outcomes. Number 3. Show up every day. Marcus Aurelius often emphasized the importance of consistent effort and persistence in his writings. While he didn't use the exact phrase, "show up every day," his reflections and meditations convey this sentiment clearly. A relevant passage is, "At dawn, when you have trouble getting out of bed, tell yourself, 'I have to go to work as a human being. What do I have to complain of if I'm going to do what I was born for? The things I was brought into the world to do? Or is this what I was created for? To huddle under the blankets and stay warm?'" This passage reflects the idea of showing up every day and fulfilling one's responsibilities with dedication and purpose. Aurelius emphasizes the importance of rising to meet each day with the intention of performing one's duties and contributing to the world. His Stoic philosophy encourages steadfastness and the commitment to consistently engage in actions that align with one's values and purpose. Each day presents a new arena, not for grand battles, but for demonstrating one's commitment to principles and duties. It's in the consistency and everyday effort that character is built and tested. In today's world, filled with distractions and fleeting motivations, the importance of showing up every day is even more pronounced. It's easy to feel inspired one day and lose focus the next. Here, Stoicism teaches us the value of consistency. True discipline is cultivated not through intensity, but through the regularity of our actions. This doesn't mean every day needs to be highly productive. Rather, it's about not letting a day slip by unnoticed or unutilized. Whether advancing in our career, improving our health, or deepening our relationships, progress in any area requires the simple, often overlooked commitment to show up every day. Moreover, showing up daily is intertwined with the Stoic practice of mindfulness, being present and doing today's work today, without being burdened by yesterday's failures or tomorrow's worries. Marcus Aurelius wrote extensively about focusing on the present and doing the task at hand to the best of one's ability. This focus transforms routine into ritual and effort into improvement. To cultivate this discipline, start small. Decide what showing up means for you. It could be as simple as writing a paragraph of that book you've been meaning to write, doing a 5-minute workout, or spending 10 uninterrupted minutes with a loved one. The scale is not what transforms us. It's the act of showing up each day and meeting your commitment. This reinforces your willpower and builds the resilience central to Stoic philosophy. By adopting this daily practice, you embody the Stoic belief in personal responsibility and continuous self-improvement. You become a testament to the idea that while we may not control outcomes, we can control our efforts. In the consistent act of showing up, we find the discipline necessary to lead a purposeful and fulfilling life. Number 4. Embrace voluntary hardship. The Stoic practice of voluntary hardship, strongly supported by Marcus Aurelius, is about more than just making life intentionally difficult. It's about preparing for life's unpredictability, building resilience, and deepening appreciation for what we have. Marcus Aurelius, like many Stoics, believed that experiencing discomfort voluntarily helps to strengthen the mind for times when life imposes discomfort upon us. This might involve foregoing certain luxuries, enduring physical challenges, or practicing self-denial in small, everyday decisions. The idea is simple. If you are used to hardship, sudden adversities won't unsettle you. You're effectively training your resilience, ensuring you can face challenges with calmness and composure. But why seek discomfort in a world that constantly seeks to provide comfort? The answer lies in the essence of Stoic philosophy. Growth often occurs at the edges of our comfort zones. By voluntarily stepping into less comfortable situations, we not only test our mental and emotional limits, but also expand them. This practice isn't about self-punishment, but about shifting our perspective from seeing comfort as a given to viewing it as a privilege. Voluntary hardship can also foster gratitude. It's easy to take everyday comforts for granted, but occasionally living without them makes us appreciate them more deeply. For instance, skipping a meal can enhance your appreciation for food, or choosing to walk instead of drive can increase your gratitude for mobility and health. Additionally, voluntary hardship connects us to the reality that many people face involuntary hardships every day. This connection can foster empathy, humility, and a deeper understanding of the human condition, grounding us more firmly in the shared reality of the world. How can we integrate this practice into our lives? Start small. Choose something manageable. Perhaps wake up an hour earlier, limit your use of technology for a day, or take the stairs instead of the elevator. The key isn't in the magnitude of the hardship, but in the consistency and intention behind it. Each act of voluntary discomfort is a step toward greater mental fortitude and self-discipline. Number 5. Practice the dichotomy of control. This principle differentiates between what we can and cannot control, urging us to focus our energy on what we can influence. This seemingly simple concept can significantly transform how we handle life's challenges, reducing anxiety and fostering peace and resilience. So, what is within our control? According to Stoicism, it's primarily our actions, reactions, and judgments, our thoughts, will, and responses. These are the areas where we have agency. Everything external, like the weather, other people's actions, or global events, is beyond our direct control. Marcus Aurelius frequently emphasized this in his meditations, noting that becoming upset by things outside our control is not only futile, but also harmful to our well-being. Practicing the dichotomy of control begins with this understanding. While we can influence external events, we cannot fully control them. The Stoic accepts this not passively, but as a liberating truth. By focusing on our own actions and letting go of our attachment to outcomes, we can maintain tranquility and effectiveness regardless of circumstances. This doesn't mean becoming indifferent or detached from the world. Instead, we engage with it more constructively, directing our efforts where they can make a difference. In daily life, applying the dichotomy of control means asking ourselves, "Is this within my control?" before reacting to any situation. If it's not, the Stoic practice is to let it go and move on. This requires practice, mindfulness, and occasional reminders of what is truly within our sphere of influence. Additionally, this practice affects how we set goals and expect outcomes. While striving to achieve our goals, tying our happiness or self-worth to outcomes influenced by numerous external factors leads to frustration. Instead, Stoicism teaches us to find satisfaction in the pursuit itself, in adhering to our values, and in the effort we put forth. Marcus Aurelius and other Stoic philosophers did not promise a life without challenges. Instead, they offered a strategy for maintaining inner peace and dignity despite life's ups and downs. By practicing this principle, we enhance our own lives and positively influence those around us through our example of calmness and resilience in the face of life's inevitable uncertainties. Number 6. Never play the victim. This principle emphasizes a deep understanding of personal responsibility and the Stoic commitment to self-mastery. Instead of adopting a victim mentality, where one views themselves as a passive recipient of life's difficulties, Stoicism encourages us to take control of our perceptions and reactions. This empowerment is central to the Stoic belief that our happiness and peace of mind are determined more by our internal state than by external events. The idea is not to deny the difficulties or injustices one might face, but to shift focus from what happens to us to how we respond. Aurelius believed that every external event presents a choice. How will we let this define us? By refusing to play the victim, we reject the notion that our emotional well-being is controlled by external circumstances. This realization is liberating and fosters personal growth and resilience. Practicing this principle starts with observing our habitual responses to challenging situations. Do we blame external factors or others? Do we waste energy complaining instead of addressing the situation? Changing these patterns isn't about suppressing our feelings, but understanding them more deeply and redirecting our energies constructively. It involves acknowledging our pains and disappointments while recognizing our capacity to move forward despite them. Additionally, this Stoic teaching encourages us to see every obstacle as an opportunity to practice virtue and strengthen our character. This perspective is proactive and empowering, transforming potential feelings of helplessness into moments of choice where we can assert our agency. Each challenge becomes a test of our commitment to our values and an opportunity to demonstrate fortitude, perseverance, and resilience, qualities central to the Stoic ideal. By never playing the victim, we embody the Stoic ideal of emotional independence. We develop an inner fortress of calm and equanimity from which we can engage with the world more fully and freely. This doesn't mean becoming emotionless or indifferent, but achieving a state where our happiness isn't easily disrupted by life's ups and downs. Thus, we live not at the mercy of our circumstances, but in alignment with our deepest principles, regardless of what life throws our way. Number 7. Practice delayed gratification. Marcus Aurelius advocated for this principle not just as a personal discipline, but as a pathway to greater freedom and satisfaction. In the Stoic perspective, mastering one's impulses by delaying gratification isn't about denying pleasure, but about achieving a higher form of fulfillment that aligns with one's values and long-term goals. Delayed gratification involves strategically postponing immediate desires to gain more significant and enduring rewards. It's about making choices that may not offer instant satisfaction, but lead to lasting well-being and personal growth. This principle is particularly relevant in our modern culture of instant gratification, where the ability to wait for something better is a rare and valuable skill. For Stoics like Aurelius, practicing delayed gratification was also about maintaining mastery over one's desires. He believed that being enslaved to fleeting pleasures could lead to a loss of freedom, as one becomes captive to their whims and impulses. Instead, by exercising restraint and making decisions based on reason and foresight, we cultivate a life not just of temporary pleasures, but of lasting tranquility and contentment. Implementing delayed gratification in everyday life can start with simple habits. It might mean saving money rather than spending it impulsively, choosing a healthy meal over fast food, or dedicating time to study or practice a skill instead of opting for immediate leisure activities. Each of these choices reinforces the Stoic practice of prioritizing long-term benefits over short-term ease or pleasure. Moreover, the benefits of this practice are extensive. Psychological research supports the Stoic view, linking delayed gratification to better outcomes in career, education, health, and personal relationships. People who can postpone immediate gratification are often better at handling stress, reaching their goals, and living healthier, more fulfilling lives. Number 8. Ignore naysayers. This principle extends beyond simply disregarding negative feedback. It involves developing mental resilience to remain committed to your convictions and goals despite doubt and skepticism from others. For Stoics, the approval or disapproval of others is beyond one's control and should not be a source of personal validation or guidance. Marcus Aurelius wrote extensively about focusing only on actions and opinions within one's control, emphasizing that true peace comes from within and cannot be disturbed by external judgments. This Stoic indifference is not about dismissing others, but about maintaining an internal locus of control, filtering out noise that doesn't serve your higher purposes or align with your values. In practical terms, ignoring naysayers is crucial in our modern world where opinions are abundant and criticism is easily shared. It means recognizing that while constructive feedback can be valuable, baseless criticism should not deter us from our path. Stoicism teaches us to evaluate the source and intent of criticism. Is it informed? Is it well-meaning? Does it align with our core values? Practicing this principle means building a personal philosophy robust enough to withstand external pressures. It's about having confidence in your decisions and actions, not out of arrogance, but from a deep understanding of your own values and objectives. This was a daily practice for Marcus Aurelius, not just as a ruler, but as a person striving for virtue in a complex world. Ignoring naysayers enhances emotional resilience, making us less reactive to negative opinions and more focused on our long-term vision. In a culture that often emphasizes social validation, being able to step outside this cycle and stay true to oneself is both rare and powerful. Embracing the Stoic practice of ignoring naysayers protects our mental space and directs our emotional energy where it truly matters. It's about not letting external noise distract us from our internal dialogue, the one that genuinely shapes our lives. Number 9. Find wise people to emulate. This concept is based on the idea that much of our learning and personal growth comes from observing and reflecting on the lives of those who have mastered virtues we aspire to develop. Emulating wise individuals isn't about copying them, but about learning from their example to enhance our own character and judgment. Marcus Aurelius, despite being an emperor, often wrote about his admiration for the qualities of others, both past and present. He saw emulating these figures as a way to internalize their strengths and virtues. For him and other Stoics, wisdom wasn't just theoretical knowledge but a practical guide to living well, best understood through the actions of those who have effectively applied these principles. In the context of Stoicism, choosing whom to emulate involves recognizing those who embody the Stoic virtues of wisdom, courage, justice, and temperance. These could be historical figures, contemporaries, or even characters from stories and literature who demonstrate qualities such as resilience, ethical integrity, and rational thinking. The key is to look for individuals whose lives provide a roadmap for facing challenges with grace and determination. Applying this principle today involves thoughtfully selecting role models whose values align with our aspirations. It's about more than just admiration. It's about critically observing how these individuals navigate their lives, make decisions, and handle adversity. This practice encourages us to ask, what about this person's approach or mindset can I incorporate into my own life to improve my conduct and choices? Moreover, emulating wise individuals helps bridge the gap between abstract philosophical concepts and everyday actions. It provides concrete examples of how Stoic principles can be lived out. This not only makes these ideals more accessible, but also more compelling, as we see the tangible impact of Stoic virtues in the lives of those we respect. In seeking out and emulating wise people, we engage in a dynamic form of learning and self-improvement. It's a proactive approach to personal development that reinforces our commitment to growth and excellence. By surrounding ourselves with the influence of virtuous individuals, we set a high standard for our own behavior and decisions, propelling ourselves toward becoming the wise individuals we seek to emulate. Number 10. Honestly review your day. This practice goes beyond merely recalling events. It entails a deep and reflective examination of one's thoughts, actions, and responses throughout the day. It involves assessing whether these behaviors were in line with one's values and Stoic virtues such as wisdom, justice, courage, and moderation. This introspective process is essential as it serves as a feedback mechanism that enhances awareness of one's actions and decisions. For Stoics, the aim of this daily review isn't to dwell on mistakes or engage in self-criticism, but rather to observe and make adjustments. It's about learning from each day's experiences and using that knowledge for continuous self-improvement. Marcus Aurelius employed this technique to ensure he fulfilled his duties as an emperor while evolving as a philosopher and individual. Incorporating this practice into modern life can be highly beneficial. It prompts ending each day with a moment of quiet reflection. During this time, one can pose several key questions to oneself. How did I handle challenges today? Did my actions reflect my principles? What could I have done differently? Were there instances where I lost control and why? Reflecting on these questions fosters greater self-awareness and guides toward living a more deliberate and intentional life. Furthermore, this practice can instill a sense of peace and closure at the end of each day. It enables addressing any lingering thoughts or stresses directly rather than carrying them into the next day. This is particularly impactful in our fast-paced world where it's easy to lose sight of deeper goals amid daily distractions and pressures. By honestly reviewing the day, one engages in a form of self-accountability that is both gentle and rigorous. It involves recognizing strengths and acknowledging areas for improvement without judgment. This Stoic habit cultivates resilience and wisdom, positioning oneself as both student and teacher in life's journey, continually learning from personal experiences and striving to embody Stoic virtues. Over time, this practice can reshape not only how days are perceived, but also how life is lived, aligning more closely with cherished ideals with each passing day. Thank you for embarking on this journey into the essence of Stoicism and the enduring wisdom of Marcus Aurelius.